Hey there everyone, PhilChill here and welcome to my channel. We all want to have a huge quantity of prismatic shards just to use for ourselves, since there are so many uses in the game now. In the 1.4 update, tailoring was added and you could use prismatic shards to create a tailoring recipe. Also, you could buy a magic rock candy from the desert trader for 3 prismatic shards. But now, with the 1.5 update, a new use was added, and that was at the forge. At the forge in the volcano dungeon, you can now enchant weapons and tools using a single prismatic shard. But the enchantment is random, so you will probably need a lot of tries to get the correct enchantment for your tool or weapon, using a lot of prismatic shards in the process. Today, I will show you a way you can get a great quantity of prismatic shards for your playthrough and also a bunch of rare and useful items for your farm. So, without further ado, let's begin. Prismatic shards are valuable and they can be used to get the galaxy sword, trade them in with the desert trader, craft tailoring recipes or enchant your weapons or tools. But they are quite rare to find and you'll need a great number of them for your playthrough. So, a lot of people have been looking for ways that they can get prismatic shards more easily. And there is a way that you can do that, with a single skull caverns run. But in order to do this, you'll need to be ready to invest a bit for that run. For this to work, firstly, you need to secure a great deal of staircases. And you can do just that with a simple trick, and that is by duplicating jade in the crystallariums and just trade that in for staircases at the desert trader on Sundays. I have made a whole video on this topic, and I will leave it in the description below that you can check it out. That video is about farming Iridium. So with that, you can kill 2 birds with 1 stone. For the next part, it will be a bit more difficult since you will need to procure a single magic rock candy. You can get this item by exchanging 3 prismatic shards at the desert trader on Thursdays for 1 magic rock candy. This is quite a gamble since it's really expensive using 3 prismatic shards to buy one of those. The alternative in getting 1 magic rock candy is by getting it as a drop from the hunted skulls or by donating 90 items in the museum. This food is really important for this trick to work since it gives you +5 to your luck, which will boost your luck in the skull caverns, increasing the chance of finding prismatic shards and more. And in combination with the ginger ale, which was cooked with the key seasoning, it will give you +2 to your luck to a total of +7 luck for the day. And you will just need to check the TV daily for a really great luck day so you can start doing this trick. 2 other sources of luck in the game are the van next to the Jojo Mart, which can give you +0.025 permanent luck buff after you complete its request, which is unlocked from the secret notes. This will get your luck before you start, which is so crazy, and knowing that we can get to that luck level just with those items, but we can further increase it by 1 just by getting a lucky ring, which increases our luck level by +1 for a total of +8 luck, which will be so epic for a single skull caverns run. But firstly, you'll need to be really lucky in order to find the lucky ring, since it's really rare in the game. So you can follow this guide even without the lucky ring. Just start your run on a really great luck day, get your food buffs and head on down in the skull caverns. As you can see from this chart, the mummies and the serpents from the skull caverns have a 0.1% chance of dropping a prismatic shard, while the shadow people have a 0.05%. making the skull caverns a more suitable like location to farm the prismatic shards. From fishing, the chance from finding a treasure chest is 0.014%, while keeping a rainbow trout on your farm in a fish pond has a 0.09% chance of daily producing a prismatic shard. And for the skull caverns, the Iridium nodes have a 4% chance of producing a prismatic shard, while finding a mystic stone has a 25% chance of dropping a prismatic shard. This has the highest amount of percentage in the game for finding a prismatic shard, but also it's quite rare. And the last but not least, the treasure rooms in the Skull Caverns have a 4% chance of containing a prismatic shard inside them. The most important thing when you're doing this trick is to just go down in the mines until you find treasure floors. It's best using the Master Stealing Shot in combination with the explosive ammo to hit nearby Iridium nodes without going further from the staircases, so you don't waste precious time. The treasure floors with this trick will be quite abundant, and you can find quite the rare items like auto-petters, auto-grabbers, which are really rare but are quite important to have. The auto-petter is the best, however, since you won't be losing any of the hearts that you've gotten with your animals. Over the time you'll see some enemies pop out, but you should just go straight down until you get some iridium nodes that you can like break close by. It's really important that you should save your time as much, and you should not go further away if you don't see any iridium nodes near the staircases. It's best only to break those and continue downwards on this farm. These kind of runs are quite efficient, and you'll get a lot of items from the treasure floors, from the iridium nodes and stone nodes that you break, and also gems along the way. With the slingshot, the efficiency is increased at the max since you just stand at the stairs and shoot at all of the nodes near you. The only problem is it's a bit hard to kill some of the nodes that are close by to you with the slingshot, and you need a long time to adjust to the way it shoots. That's why the luck buff food is really important, and maxing out your luck before doing these kinds of runs can make a huge difference in the items that you get and also the quantity of the raw materials that you can find. It's really important to know that every run that you do, you should do only on the greatest of the luck days, and by using the luck buff food, finding prismatic shards can be a piece of cake. Along the way you will get a lot of clothing like the cowboy hats, the turban and more, the auto-petter, the prismatic shards and all of the artisan equipment like the crystallarium, the auto-grabber and more. This run was quite efficient, and we got a huge amount of items that we can use. We managed to get quite the number of sprinklers, we managed to get 3 auto-petters, 1 auto-grabber, 1 crystallarium, 1 seed maker, 5 prismatic shards, and a bunch of items that are like slime, hats and more. The most important are the prismatic shards, however, since we're doing this video for, but we didn't get a lot, but we got our investment back with 2 more extra along the way. So if you do this again, you'll get more in the future. In any case, that's all I have for you today. What's the best route that you can choose to get more prismatic shards as well? Let me know down below. But don't forget to like the video, since it helps me out a lot, and subscribe to my channel if you'd like to see more content like this in the future. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you all in my next one. But till then, stay safe.